Interested in latest developments for designing your virtual ECU? Don't miss the top 5 new features of vVIRTUALtarget. Hi, my name is Christian and I'm the product manager for vVIRTUALtarget. In this video, I'll show you the top 5 highlights of the latest vVIRTUALtarget version 8. So let's get started. To make you understand the first feature, we are rebuilding this project. The build fails, saying that you need a new version of KenoEmu, which is an important library that essentially hosts our microcontroller emulation. Traditionally, this library is part of your microZAR package, which may cause an inconsistency between your microZAR delivery and the tool installation. The good news is that starting from version 8, we'll ship this library with vVIRTUALtarget. Just choose the library that came with the tool. So let's rebuild and see what happens. All right, that works. And you have one thing less to worry about. We keep on adding new features to the platform emulation library, which brings me to the second highlight. It now comes with an integrated XCP server. XCP is the universal measurement and calibration protocol, which is widely used for watching and modifying ECU RAM contents. The integrated server provides a dedicated XCP over TCP endpoint, which operates independently of your virtual ECU's bus connectors. This way, the feature works with both level 1 and level 3 vECUs and with any calibration tool, including Canopy and Canoe option AMD. We've been emphasizing the everything as code paradigm for several years now. This is why vVIRTUALtarget 5 introduced the VTTMAKE file format, which is now widely used in CI pipelines. To simplify the migration to VTTMAKE, we now offer a handy little tool that converts the existing project format to the command line based solution, as you can see it here. The fourth highlight is about the vVIRTUALtarget port monitoring, short VTTPM, which is a powerful mechanism to observe and instrument communication between software components. To configure the instrumentation process, you need to provide a VTTPM file. The capabilities of VTTPM files are also powerful. So, especially new users might struggle somewhat with getting their content right. Because modifying existing content is easier than creating it from scratch, version 8 creates an exemplary VTTPM file for you. So, you can just modify this file at your discretion and rename it accordingly. Alternatively, you might want to copy the contents over to your VTTMAKE file. One last feature I want to mention is the VCDL generation. If you are dealing with level 1 vECUs, you might have noticed that vVIRTUALtarget generates a file with extension VCODM. This file contains the vECU interface description, but only machines would enjoy reading it. Starting with version 8, vVIRTUALtarget generates a different file format, VCDL, which stands for Vector Communication Description Language. It is natively supported by Canoe, easy to understand, and follows our everything as code paradigm. Enjoy working with it. With these new features, we aim to simplify the virtualization of your ECU. We are constantly working on new features to support you to develop and test your virtualized AutoZAR project. Feel free to comment or contact us to let us know what features you need or if you maybe would like a deep dive session regarding a particular feature. Thank you for watching. Stay up to date on new features and get insights into vVIRTUALtarget and other Vector products. Just subscribe to our Vector Tech tutorial channel and hit the bell.